representation of blind force. So when he holds that, I'm looking at my energy, sending my energy, which is pressure and direction, toward his center line. So if I'm my relationship to him and his center of force, so let's say the axis in which I have to rotate around, let's say it's about here. So, and obviously, clearly, it's down here, down towards center, that center line. So we're looking at lines of force that I would have to direct toward him. If I direct a line of force this way, all of a sudden it goes to his heel. So what I have to do then is a subtle change changes the energy where I send it. I should also subtly change my base. So my hips are in this line now. And then I'm sending it again towards there. It's really easy. It doesn't require a lot of force. So if I just take my thumb and I go again, I'm driving this line towards there, and that goes right to his heel, but I subtly change it. Okay. Turns a big guy like this over just because of the instability in the base. And a lot of people will have even more instability if they turn their foot up. So let's turn that foot up. It's gonna feel weird right off the bat. He knows he's off base. So even with that, if he's holding this finger, that's all it takes. So we're looking at him locking this to his hips. So this is gonna be a representation of his hips right now, because by proxy, we've moved it out away from his body, but it's the same type of motion. If I'm going like this and sending it back, even that's not super stable just because that foot is turned up. If he turns the heel back and then rotates this one in, see, now he's in a much stronger base. I can feel that. I can no longer push him straight back. I can still go to the subtle end of it because I work around his core. So when we start training this, we look at going from here to here. So now, if I'm sending my step out here and hoping that it moves him, it's a little bit of wasted energy. So what I need to do is shift my base and go back to his weak point. So again, this is the line of energy. This doesn't lie. This is our connection between us. This says I have to buttress my force to a 90-degree pressure to send directly to his line. If it goes to his heel, then I change my angle. The longer we make the stick, the greater angle I have to do this. So this is a bigger representation. But then I just send the force right down that line, and it's very little effort to get them off their base. Again, this happens in tenths of a second during a fight, but it's really effective. So if I'm going like this, and the line is telling me I have to give force this way, but my base is turned so that I'm sending force this way, and I try to shear into here, he's gonna feel that and he'll pull me. He'll just pull it, and I'll be over. And he can feel that, because this is information exchange. When I go here to do this, not only have I, just my relationship to him tells me how I should do this, but I'm also sending information to him as soon as I make contact. So if I'm going from there to this, not only am I reading where his base is by subtle pressure and subtle turn, but he's also getting my information. He now reads what I'm doing, and he can shift his base or do whatever else. But for training purposes, we just have him be solid. So his legs are connected, he stays in his position regardless of what I do. So then I'll shift. So I'm looking at this subtle change here. Again, around that core, I'm just rotating just a little bit. If I go here, I'm gonna do a gross exaggeration back to his pressure on his heel. And again, I don't go like this, elbows in. I send energy there. He's solid. So what I do is a subtle shift, and a subtle shift here sends him off in the right direction. But it's only because I'm countered in my base fairly strong. So I can send this here because if he pushes back on me, I'm solid. So that means I can direct solid energy back to him. That's one way to test whether or not you're giving the line of energy properly. So if I shift my base like this, and I'm pushing, okay? He pushes back on me, and I fall, that means I wasn't setting my base properly. So now the closer we are to the opponent, meaning we're in this base, I'm doing some shifts to take him off his balance. And when we say base is a little different than balance. Although they do affect one another, we're a little closer to the center because I'm not strong enough to do it. So now this is an accurate representation of my position to him and the line of force that I have to apply. Again, this does not lie. This is a representation of his core. So if we went straight down to his center line, I have to send energy to that. Again, like when he had the triangle and we're looking for that, I'm looking to put him back here. So when I shift, I go here. That's all it takes. That works when I strike. If I punch on that line, it takes his base. I break down the structure of his foundation, which is what we're looking at. So things like this help a lot because it helps determine this angle, that this line of force that does not lie. This is information that tells me directly where I have to apply stuff. So when you're training somebody, you can look at this, and the lightest touches on this, you can move to find their weak point in their base. See, all he's going to do is be solid. He's getting a lot of information. He's learning a lot from this also, because he now knows exactly where he's weak in his base. So what you're trying to do when you train somebody is to go at the minimum, the weakest amount of energy that you can put towards something. See, if I'm going to the solid part of the base, not working. So I give up on that. I do a subtle shift right there. Very little energy to move somebody like that. So now when we're working, that sort of thing comes into play when we're struggling against each other. So when I'm fighting him, again, my subtle movements against a guy that's much stronger, heavier than I am, and it doesn't take me very much to start taking him off base, and he's working to counter my strength. So if I'm giving him something, he gives me something back, right? He gives me information to tell him exactly where to put it. So if I get into the mode of I'm gonna just struggle against him, he struggles against me. Well, it's whoever's stronger is gonna make that. But what he did was he capitalized on my imbalance. And he went, because he'd been training. So he knows. So I have to work. Again, if I'm trying to do stuff like this, I have to have a pretty good read on this. For me to do something like this, that's not gonna happen. But what I can do is I can change it like that. Because now, through this information I just gained in his base, I subtly change it to where it now works. And that's through just touch here. I may be underneath, I may be here. Again, it may be when I'm hitting, I get inside like this. This is where I can have somebody move in without using a lot of energy. That's what you need when you're fighting 3, 4, 5 people. You have to have constant energy supply. And if I'm going here muscle for muscle against this guy, it's gonna be a short 30 seconds. You know, because we're all gonna be both heaving really heavily, and it's just fight strength for strength isn't gonna do anything. So right there, that's when we go. That's why it's so effortless. That's why in the clinch range, I'm not breathing as hard as a lot of other people. So I'm using very little energy to do what I need to do, which is based on that centerline knowledge, based on where I have to put energy. Because again, if I get him off base, I can capitalize on so many different things. Because he's constantly in a state of defensive counterposition. That's where you want to keep your opponent.